Basant is now a festival that no longer exists as part of Lahore's heritage, but your pictures become a frame of reference. Did you intend to preserve it when you were painting kites in your paintings?
Let me make it clear, Basant is not a Hindu festival. It is purely a festival of Lahore. It is first day of the spring, day, not night. Somehow they converted into night festival. First day of the spring is very comfortable. First night of the spring is pretty chilly. Then you see kites all over the sky during this day. You can't see those kites during the night. They say strings cut necks of so many children riding. Well, this again is our fault. There were so many trees. We have cut down the trees. Otherwise, string used to get entangled. It wouldn't go very far. This is just our first mistake. Kites that I paint over the sky, you know, it is poetic license, exaggeration. Not so many kites should have been there, but this is sort of a balance between colors of costumes of the figures in my paintings that I try to repeat in the sky, because sky is a very large portion, blue, grayish, so monotony of that is broken with kites.
So for you, it was more of breaking the monotony of the sky, but it ended up becoming a preservation of Basant. So even if the powers that be can ban Basant for posterity, they cannot remove it from your paintings. So allow me to shift gears a little bit. I'm going to bring in some counter narratives, because from what I'm hearing from you, I get a sense of nostalgia about childhood memories. But an argument can be made that if I'm an individual and I legally own a building, and I decide to sublet the facade for billboards, or another argument can be made that I'm making the streets of the inner city wider to allow for ambulances to come in, or I'm changing the landscape so that I can introduce mass transit for people who otherwise would not have access to the city. So what then is the idea of progress, according to you, and then what is public space?
We talked about Delhi. We have seen London. In Delhi, they made mass transport system underground for the old city. So old city was not disturbed. In London, they started building a tube, maybe over 150 years. That is underground. This could have been done in Lahore as well. Lahore is a mega city. It needs a mass transport system, but they have destroyed Nicholson Road, where I grew up. They pulled down Muzaffar Mansions, where I grew up. They pulled down Nanda Building. Nanda was owner of Nanda Transport Company before Omnibus came. Even Krishan Chandar lived there, Nicholson Road. They have pulled down Borwala Chowk, which had six boards. Nawabzada Nasrullah Khan lived there. They have pulled down. This is not the way. They have tried to destroy history. This is very painful. It never happens in any part of the world. This is brutality. I'm sorry for these cruel words.
Dr. Saab, you mentioned that they destroyed your home. I have your painting on the screen right now, and I believe this is Muzaffar Mansion. So just could you describe what is happening in this painting? Tell us a little bit about
it. You must have heard of Tariq Ali, activist. He was our neighbor and his grandfather was Muzaffar Ali Khan. They were our landlords. हमें कभी महसूस ही नहीं हुआ कि हम किराएदार थे. And it had its own tube well. In those days, flush system was not very common. We had flush system as well. Children used to come and hold the chain of flush, and they used to laugh. And Taira Mazhar Ali Khan, she was our neighbor. She was a horticulturist, environmentalist. She planted so many trees over there. There was an open area in front for us children. In this painting, you can see Morris Oxhold. My father is next to that. In the first story, you can see my siblings over the rooftops flying kites. And there on the side, there is, you can't see very clearly over here, Tariq Ali is peeping out of there. This was something. When we had to leave this place, my mother said, Nicholson Road, the Jannat Sikhi. And this, we shall always miss this. It remains in my mind. You, jaise maine kaha ki isko haq nahi mera bachpan mujhse chheen le, bachpan memories mein raha karta hai.
Dr. Saab, do you ever go to this neighborhood?
It's a very, very sad story. These people, they are very expert. They pull down most beautiful buildings. They pull down. Mati Haveli was pulled down overnight. Main udhar se guzarta nahi hoon kabhi bhi. Koi dost mar jaye to afsos hota hai. Banda kehta hai, main kya jaake wo bell karun aur ye awaaz doon, azar bahar aao. No, wo azar hai hi nahi, wo mar gaya hai. ये बिल्ड के भी मेरे लिए मर गई हैं. मैं उधर से गुजरना नहीं चाहता. इट हर्ट्स मी.
जा साहब, योर एक्टिविज्म हैज नॉट जस्ट बीन लिमिटेड टू पैसिवली प्रिजर्विंग बिल्डिंग्स एंड मेमोरीज एंड स्टोरीज ऑन अ पीस ऑफ पेपर. यू हैव एक्चुअली गॉन बियॉन्ड दैट. द लिंटन मार्केट इज वन सच स्टोरी वेयर यू एक्टिवली work towards the preservation of a monument. Could you tell us a bit about what happened there?
It is very tragic. Tullerton Market, originally exhibition hall, was built in 1864. They wanted to pull it down and build 11-story building instead. We launched a campaign. People said, go to the court. I said, no, we will lose there. We held press conferences, we held press processions, protest processions, and the media cooperated, the government listened. Farooq Ahmed Khan Lagari was president those days. He knew me from government college days. Though, of course, he's from Aitchison College. I said to him, in name of my children at NCA, I request Tullerton Market be saved. He ordered an inquiry, and of course it was saved. This was one singular big achievement. It is not important to win. It is more important to fight. Even if... even if you lose in the process, दूसरे party को इतना बदनाम कर दो कि वो badly जख्मी भी हो जाए और सबको पता लग जाए कि orange train के सिलसिले में कितना पैसा चाइना से लेकर खा लिया इन्होंने.
So, Tullerton is one success story. There are many others that are not so successful. What do you think about the future now, both for you and also for the city that you call your own?
Well, cities, living cities must keep changing, adapting according to the new times. languages too that don't adapt according to demands of the new time, they start becoming dead languages. So we are not against change. We are for controlled change. This change which is happening is not controlled. Liberty market was a success story. When they built Azam cloth market in the very heart of the walled city, that was a colossal mistake.
So you're 72 years now. What are you working on these days?
Well, there is always unfinished agenda. Everybody wants to praise one's father. I would say, let us say there was one person, Anwar. He created Nanna cartoon, he gave political cartoons. In his memory, I'm trying to establish a museum. Over four canals, that was all I could afford. And I'm trying to collect all his works for display and for the benefit of future researchers. They can come over here. I invite all you, a few people, you can come over here someday. And of course, one hall will be dedicated to my work, that is old Lahore that once upon was.
Ajaz Sahab, thank you so much for what you have done, not only to preserve your own childhood, but our collective childhood. So on behalf of every resident of Lahore, allow me to thank you for all that you've done, and we really appreciate you being here.